Greetings. Ever been accused of not respecting Islam? Well, here's one I received today. Oh, not to mention that you're extremely disrespectful of others' beliefs. An individual is free to choose his object of worship. The Quran itself warns not to be disrespectful to others' objects of worship. Notice the general exaggeration. To others' beliefs. First of all, the exaggeration, the extrapolation, and the ambiguity is false. I am not disrespectful to Buddhists, Hindus, Mormons, atheists, or even Satanists. I specifically have no respect for Mohammedism. But let's look in a reasoned way at this Mohammedan's allegation and learn something interesting. I'm actually having to completely rework this video content because I was too rash and hasty. I was ready to call this particular Mohammedan a liar, and I would have been wrong. Here is the part that at first reading I was sure was an intentional falsehood from the Dawa of Deception. The Quran itself warns not to be disrespectful of others' objects of worship. I did reply with a challenge to produce surah and ayat to support this, and I'm glad I did. Produce surah and ayat from the Quran stating, respect the objects of worship of other religions. Here is what the brother replied with. Surah 6, 108. But do not revile those beings whom they invoke instead of Allah, lest they revile Allah out of spite and in ignorance. For goodly indeed have we made their own doings appear unto every community. In time, however, unto their sustainer they must return, and he will make them truly understand all what they were doing. It's pretty long, but let's look at it phrase by phrase, at least the first couple phrases, because it merits the attention. The Asad. But do not revile those beings whom they invoke instead of Allah. Notice the translator addition of beings. I believe this is a legitimate extrapolation, as we shall see. But do not revile those beings whom they invoke instead of Allah. This does not speak of the pagans themselves. It is saying to not revile or insult or speak against the beings, deities, gods, the pagans pray to. And if that is the only phrase you read and you take it out of context, it might plausibly be paraphrased as respect other religions. Or respect other beings, deities, objects of worship. But that would not be an accurate understanding of this ayat. But do not revile those beings whom they invoke instead of Allah. The author is about to give you the why, the reason, the rationale. Lest they revile Allah out of spite and in ignorance. Think about the human basis of this rationale. Do not piss them off and trigger their self-defense mechanism. They will bronze rule your ass in return. You know the golden rule, right? Do unto others as you want them to do unto you. Well, the bronze rule twists and perverts that. Do unto others as they have already done unto you. The golden rule? Turn the other cheek. The bronze rule? An eye for an eye. The golden rule? God's way of love and grace and mercy. The bronze rule, Islam's twisted way of violence, brutality, and conquest. I think you can see the parallels and the inverted, twisted nature of Islam's worldview. But do not revile those beings whom they invoke instead of Allah, lest they revile Allah out of spite. Don't piss them off by insulting their God, or they'll attack your God in return. And that is a very different meaning than respect other religions. It is actually the inverse. Don't actively disrespect other religions. And you must parse this just that close to truly understand what the Quran is teaching Mohammedans to do. Because there is no respect for any other religion than Mohammedism taught by the Quran. But I think I need to give you another example from real life. This is a lesson in clear and accurate communication. Have you ever raised a child? Or are you now raising a child? Have you caught them doing something you know you would not give them permission to have done? Did you make the mistake of saying, "Don't let me catch you doing that again"? "Well, yeah, Tex. I told them not to do it again." Sorry, partner. You did not tell them, "Don't do it again." You said, "Don't let me catch you." The lesson in clear and accurate communication concerns what you thought you said and what you really said. Well, the people who read the Quran have the same problem. They see what they want to see. They read what they think they want to read. A decent human being who happens to have been deceived or tricked into Islam will read 6108 with a generous filter and see only a kind misreading of what the Quran says. Because the Quran does not say, "Respect other religions." It says, "Do not revile them." And the absolutely clear implication is, within earshot of the pagans. So keep that in mind as we read multiple translations of this ayat. "Revile not those unto whom they pray beside Allah, lest they wrongfully revile Allah through ignorance." Shakir, "And do not abuse those whom they call upon besides Allah, lest exceeding the limits they should abuse Allah out of ignorance." "And offend not those who call to other than Allah, so that they not offend Allah out of spite, without knowledge." And this one kind of confuses whether it's beings or the pagans. The Khan, "But do not revile those beings whom they invoke instead of Allah, lest they in their hostility revile Allah, and out of ignorance." The Irving, "Do not insult those they appeal to instead of to Allah, lest they insult Allah as an enemy without even realizing it." The Muntakab, "Do not assail those who incorporate with Allah other deities nor their idols with abusive language conveying injurious reproach, lest they should revile Allah in retaliation by want of thought." I'm sure old Muntakab got paid by the word. You see, the motive of the author's scheme is clearly laid out. And now that you are aware of it, keep your eyes wide open to it. And though it is nearly invisible, there is a whiff of a hint of feigned concern for the angry pagan. Without knowledge. Out of ignorance. Without even realizing it. Through ignorance. By want of thought. The Dariabadi, "Revile not those whom they invoke besides Allah, lest they may spitefully revile Allah without knowledge." As if the only justification to reject and revile Muhammad's Allah is ignorance. As if. So does the Quran say respect other religions because they are equal with Islam? Hail no! So be aware that Mohammedans probably do not even read their Quran closely enough to represent it. That means they may not be telling a known falsehood, a bold-faced lie. It is absolutely possible that they don't know their Quran as most Christians don't know their Bible, much to their shame and eternal risk. Do not be fooled. Satan is the father of lies. John 8:44, "You belong to your father, the devil, and you want to carry out your father's desires. He was a murderer from the beginning, not holding to the truth, for there is no truth in him. When he lies, he speaks his native language, for he is a liar and the father of lies. Islam is the religion Satan invented. And those programmed by Islam will say every nice thing about their religion they can. But do not trust a single word of the Dawa of deception and damnation. Dig in, like I did. Read what the Quran actually says. And while I won't cover more detail in this video, what do you think this next phrase means? For goodly indeed have we made their own doings appear unto every community. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.